Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wahda wa salatu wa salamu ala man la nabiyya ba'dah. Dear respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another brand new episode of the program entitled Towards the Origin, broadcasted live from the studio of Channel S, watched on Sky 734. To all of those who have joined with us through our Facebook page, thank you very much. And inshallah, we'll be continuing this program for an hour. You can also watch this program later on our YouTube channel. And also, if you've got any questions, suggestions, concern, please feel free to email us. The email address for your convenience will be appearing at the bottom of your TV screen. But for your kind reference, it's towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. Our tonight's discussion will be on the topic Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and Muslims. What is our relationship with him, especially in this part of the world that we live in? The celebration, festive period is on, new celebration, or perhaps the annual celebration of the country is coming up very soon. So as Muslim, what sort of knowledge should we keep? How should we interact? How should we answer to questions if we do come across any challenging question? All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll try and discuss in our tonight's discussion. But before that, the formalities must be proceeded with. We have been joined with us by a regular guest who is a respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known Mosque, Regent's Park Mosque, and also a graduate of Al-Azhar University, Fadilatul Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much for joining with us, especially in this cold weather.
It is my pleasure, Brother Qamar.
Now let's start, before we go into the details of Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, if you can just slightly define, because many a times we do get questions or we do get asked, what is the difference between Nabi and Rasul?
طيب الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. After praising Allah and sending salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I testify that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. He is one and he has no partners. And I also testify that the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the final messenger and slave of Allah, the Almighty. Now, as Brother Qamar asked, the difference between a Nabi and Rasul, which is a very common question we receive. So a Nabi, which is known as Prophet, who came to this world in order to remind the people of the world about the teaching of the early prophets. Whereas a Rasul, he comes to the world with a new Sharia, with a new doctrine, with a new law, with a new manhaj. So this is the difference. So every Rasul is a Nabi, but not every Nabi is a Rasul.
So this is where the technical issue is. A lot of people do get confused between the difference between the two.
Yeah.
Now, how do we understand, I mean, what's the basic difference between the Nabi and Rasul?
So Nabi is somebody who comes, for example, after Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, after Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, many prophets came to this world to remind the teaching of the early prophets, those who came with Sharia. So there are prophets like Harun, Lut. They came to remind the people of the early, or remind the people of the world about the teaching of early prophets.
Which means whereas the continuation.
Rasul, yes, continuation. Yeah. Whereas Rasul comes with a new religion, such as Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is a Rasul. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam is a Rasul. Muhammad Rasulullah salam is a Rasul, the messenger.
Now, when you say new religion, I mean, just to avoid a little bit of confusion, you mean the new message or the new revelation?
Updated. I mean, so the Sharia difference. There are, Sharia's a difference, meaning the prophets came with a different doctrines, whereas the deen or aqidah is one.
Okay.
So they had one faith, which is the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
They were the same.
Yes, but they had different religions or different sharia, because sharia is law, and law will change from time to time, place to place.
So basically the legislation is because it depends on the tribes, the time, the generation, the type of people.
দিন অর্থাৎ আকিদা বিশ্বাস কিন্তু পরিবর্তন হয় না অর্থাৎ মুসলমানরা এবং সৈয়দনা ঈসা আলাইহিস সালামের যারা অনুসারী ছিলেন মুসা আলাইহিস সালামের অনুসারী যারা ছিলেন সবাই কিন্তু তাওহীদের উপর দাওয়াত দিয়েছেন সবাই তাওহীদের উপর কিন্তু অবস্থান করছিলেন অর্থাৎ আল্লাহর একত্ববাদ আল্লাহ রাব্বুল আলামিন এক ও অভিন্ন
তার মানে হচ্ছে যে বেসিক ফান্ডামেন্টাল প্রিন্সিপাল কিন্তু সমান সব সময় দ্য মেসেজ দ্য কোর মেসেজ ওয়াজ সেম
আকীদা ওয়াজ সেম দ্য ফেইথ দ্য ফান্ডামেন্টাল ফেইথ অ্যাবাউট আল্লাহ অ্যাবাউট দ্য কনসেপ্ট অফ গড ওয়াজ one, but the difference of Sharia, halal, haram, certain things were allowed in the early religions, early Sharia, but then prohibited in the Sharia Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Certain things were prohibited at that time, but now allowed. So this is how it changed from time to time and place to place. Now, let's just begin this tonight's session. We're talking about a great messenger and prophet of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, known as Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, or in English we say Jesus Christ, peace be upon him.
The biblical name.
Biblical name, yes, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. So first of all, we just want to understand like how many prophets came to this world. So according to some narrations which suggest that there are some 124,000 people, prophets and messengers came to this world. But of course, there are more than one narration, some say 150,000, you know, it's just not exactly known how many prophets came, but there are some narrations suggesting the narrations of the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasul Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kisu kisu hadith onujayi, amra jante parchi je tulnamulok 124,000 Anbiya Karam ei duniyar moddhe prerito hoyechilen unara aschilen. So this is just a figure of 124,000 prophets came to this world. And then we see in the Noble Quran, we find 25 prophets are mentioned in the Noble Quran by names. Quran shorir moddhe kintu 25 jon nobir naam newa hoyeche ebong naam mention kora hoyeche. But again, within these 25 prophets, we find there are some special prophets, five special prophets in the Noble Quran.
Special bolte ki bojhen?
Unaderke Allah pak rabbul alamin extra daitto diyechilen ebong unader shariate unader onushari onek beshi chilen ebong unaderke bola hoyeche ulul azmi minar rusul. Quran al-Karim boleche ulul azmi minar rusul. ওই আম্বে কারামদের মধ্যে যারা হচ্ছেন ওনাদের মধ্যে হচ্ছেন নবী নূহ আলাইহিস সালাতু ওয়াসালাম. উনি কিন্তু খুবই গুরুত্বপূর্ণ নবী ছিলেন এবং ওনার কৌমের সাথে অনেকেই জানেন যে 950 বছর উনি দাওয়াতের কাজ করেছিলেন. হি ওয়াজ ইনভাইটিং পিপল টু ইসলাম টু দ্য ওয়ে অফ আল্লাহ ফর অ্যাবাউট 950,000 ইয়ার্স আল ফাসানাতিন ইল্লা 50 আমা. বাট you know only 950 years he lived in this world. 950 বছর উনি আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিনের দাওয়াত দিয়েছেন এবং মানুষদেরকে হেদায়েতের পথে ডেকেছিলেন. And then we find Sayyidina Ibrahim Khalilullah, of course, another great and important prophet, the father of Muslims, and the one who gave the name Islam, who was Sammakum al-Muslimin, and the one who named us as Muslims. And all the Semitic religions, meaning Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, go back to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. So he's an important prophet in Quran. Then we find Nabi Musa Kalimullah. So Musa alayhi salam was another great prophet. আরেকজন কিন্তু গুরুত্বপূর্ণ নবী এই বিশ্বের মধ্যে এসেছিলেন নবী মূসা আলাইহিস সালাতু ওয়াসালাম, এবং ওনার টাইটেল ছিল কালিমুল্লাহ. এবং তারপর আমরা দেখছি নবী ঈসা আলাইহিস সালাতু ওয়াসালাম, অর্থাৎ জিসাস ক্রাইস্ট, পিস বি আপন হিম. আরেকজন কিন্তু গুরুত্বপূর্ণ নবী এই বিশ্বের মধ্যে প্রেরিত হয়েছিলেন, এবং বিশেষ করে উনি বানি ইসরায়েল এসেছিলেন. উনি হি কেম টু দ্য চিলড্রেন অফ ইসরায়েল, সো হি কেম টু দ্য জুইশ কমিউনিটি এট দ্যাট টাইম. And the last prophet came to this world, and he's part of the Ulul Azmi Minar Rusul, is Al-Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Khatimul Anbiya Ibn Mursaleen, the final messenger and the leader of all the prophets and messengers, Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
So that means there will not be any more prophets coming after Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam.
Yes, and Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he made it very clear. He said, أنا خاتم النبيين لا نبي بعدي ولا رسول. I am the final messenger and last prophet, and there's no prophet and messenger after me. And Quran also makes it very clear, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was a رسول الله, messenger of Allah, and خاتم النبيين, and the last of the
seal
prophets,
of prophethood.
Or seal of prophethood.
So that means in terms of Aqidah, according to Islam, those who believe that if there is anyone coming after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would they be classified?
So this is actually unanimously agreed. It's not about speaking evil about anybody, but it's just a agreement, or unanimous agreement of the Muslim scholars, whether they're Sunni or even Shia, that there is no prophet after the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So just a belief.
Thank you.
Unanimously
for clarifying it.
So then, talking about Ulul Azmi Minar Rusul, the five major prophets. But then we see out of these five, three prophets came to this world, and they brought three major religions towards the end. So you've got Judaism, Musa alayhi salam, Christianity, Isa alayhi salam, and Islam, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi
salam.
These three religions have been given a special name in Quran al-Karim. Quran al-Karim, kintu ei anbiya karam derke ei tinjon ke kintu a special নাম দিয়েছে এবং এই নামটা হচ্ছে আহলুল কিতাব, দ্য পিপল অফ দ্য বুকস, জাস্ট এ স্পেশাল টাইটেল, দ্য পিপল অফ দ্য বুকস। দ্য রিজন ওয়াই কোরআন সেজ আহলুল কিতাব বিকজ দের আর লট অফ সিমিলারিটিস বিটুইন আহলুল কিতাব অ্যান্ড ইভেন ইউ নো দি ম্যারেজ ইজ অ্যালাউড উইথ দ্য পিপল অফ দ্য বুকস, ইউ নো অ্যাজ স্কলার্স হ্যাভ মেনশন। অফ কোর্স দের আর ডিফারেন্স অফ ওপিনিয়ন্স অ্যান্ড ওয়েদার ইট ইজ বেটার অর নট বেটার, দ্যাটস এ ডিফারেন্ট সাবজেক্ট, বাট দের ইজ এ জাওয়াজ ইন টার্মস অফ দ্য ম্যারেজ উইথ দ্য পিপল অফ বুকস অ্যাজ ইসলাম says. So people of the books again have been given a special name, al-Yahudiyya wal-Nasra wal-Masihiyya wal-Islam. These are the three religions given a special name as Ahlul Kitab. So talking about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, I believe it's an important thing that we listen carefully that how actually Islam or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam being an Arab, being somebody he's in, being someone he's in Mecca, an Arab Nabi, উনি কিন্তু বানি ইসরায়েলের নয়, উনি কিন্তু ফিলিস্তিন থেকে নয়, উনি মক্কায় মুকাররমা অর্থাৎ আরব গোত্রের একজন নবী। উনি কীভাবে মুসা ঈসা আলাইহিস সালাম এবং মুসা আলাইহিস সালাম এবং অন্যান্য আম্বিয়াদের ব্যাপারে উনি কীভাবে সুন্দরভাবে উনি প্রশংসা করেছেন, ওনাদের কথা ওনাদের সম্পর্কে ভালো মন্তব্য করে গেছেন, এটা কিন্তু উই মাস্ট টেক ইন অ্যাকাউন্ট। ওয়াই অ্যান আরব প্রফেট উড কাম অ্যান্ড স্পিক রিয়েলি হাই অফ দি আদার প্রফেটস, দিস সামথিং দ্যাট উই নিড টু
When you see other prophets, non-Arab prophets.
Exactly, like okay. the prophets from Israel, the prophets of even before, why would someone come and speak really good about Isa alayhi salam who was sent to the Bani Israel? Why would he speak good about Musa alayhi salam and other of course prophets? And yep,
তো এইখান থেকে একটা শিক্ষা নেওয়া যায়, যখন ওয়েন উই ট্রাই টু ইনসাল্ট ও উই ট্রাই টু ক্লাসিফাই আর ওন পিপল, সেটিং অ্যান এক্সাম্পল দ্যাট ইভেন হু আর আউস ডিফারেন্ট এথনিসিটি, ডিফারেন্ট অরিজিন, ডিফারেন্ট রেস, ইন দি ওয়ে হি ইজ গিভিং দি রেসপেক্ট
অ্যান্ড অনার,
দ্যাটস এ big lesson for us to learn.
Absolutely
here.
Right. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, when people speak about him, it's really sad. It could be a dukkhajonok bishoy. Uni ami kichu unar kichu hadith mention korbo inshallah, bornona korbo je kibhabe uni Isa alaihis salam shomporke uni bayan korechen, kibhabe uni proshongsha korechen. So let's just go back to some facts. Now we need to see there are some real facts. Now Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes an article of faith to believe in the noble prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. You cannot find any other religion which makes an article of faith to believe in Isa alayhi salam. Not even Judaism, not even any other religion. But Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes an article of faith to believe in Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in the prophethood of this great messenger. Ortat kuno musulman কখনো মুসলমান হতে পারবেন না যদি ঈসা আলাইহিস সালামকে, ঈসা আলাইহিস সালামের নবুয়তের উপরে, ঈসা আলাইহিস সালাম নবী হিসাবে যদি উনি বিশ্বাস না করেন, উনি কোনো সময়ই মুসলমান হতে পারবেন না। হি ক্যান নেভার বি মুসলিম ও শি ক্যান নেভার বি মুসলিম ইফ হি ও শি ডিসবিলিভস ইন ঈসা আলাইহিস সালাম। অ্যান্ড ওয়াই জাস্ট ঈসা, বাট পার্ট অফ দ্য মুসলিম ফেইথ, ওয়েন উই লার্নড ইমান মুফাসসাল, ইফ ইউ রিমেম্বার ব্যাক ইন দ্য ডেইজ, উই সে দ্যার আর সিক্স আর্টিকলস অফ ফেইথ ইন ইমান মুফাসসাল। সো উই সে আমানতু বিল্লাহ, মিনিং উই বিলিভড ইন আল্লাহ, আমানতু বিল্লাহি ওয়া মালাইকাতিহি, believed in the angels, wa kutubihi, believed in the books, meaning all the books, wa rusulihi, believe in every messenger and prophet. So part of the article of faith is to believe in each and every single messenger came to this world. We love them, respect them, honor them. Otherwise, we can never become a Muslim. You see, like sometimes Muslims are how sensitive. If somebody speaks anything bad about Musa alayhi salam, you see how they deal with this situation. Right. If someone speaks really, like even slightly bad about Isa alayhi salam, how Muslims become very how Muslims react to this.
Now the other issue is, now if that is the case and we believe that is the case, then yet we see a lot of allegation against Muslim.
Yes, people out there,
other faiths.
Exactly, people are thinking out there, we are enemies of these prophets, but we're not enemies. We
not only
love
the prophet,
them.
We're enemies of that particular faith as well.
Exactly, but then that's a huge misunderstanding, and that needs to be clarified and cleared. Amra ei jinish gulo ke porishkar korte hobe kintu. Amra jokhon daawati kaj amra aro beshi korte parbo, jokhon amra manusher sathe engage korte parbo, communication korte parbo, tokhon kintu ei jinish gulo kintu aro clear hoye ashbe. Time to time, gradually, এই জিনিসগুলো কিন্তু মানুষের সামনে পরিষ্কার হবে, বাট উই হ্যাভ রেসপন্সিবিলিটিস, উই হ্যাভ টু ক্যারি আউট অ্যান্ড উই হ্যাভ টু পাস দ্য মেসেজ অন টু আদার্স।
তার মানে হচ্ছে ওয়ান অফ দ্য বেস্ট ওয়ে ইজ we can integrate, and when we integrate, we have to pass on the correct message of Islam.
Absolutely correct. So the knowledge that we have and we're discussing here today, I believe that it's really important that we pass them on to others.
Now, there's another issue that we have within our society that I'm not an alim, that's not my job.
Yes, so again, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he knew that people would come and make these excuses. I'm not an imam, I'm not a sheikh, I'm not a scholar. So why should I go and give da'wah? Well, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his final pilgrimage, in his speech, "Ballighu anni walau aya." Jodi tumra amar shomporke ekti jinish jano, egulake tumra prochar koro ebong prochar korbe. Even if you know one thing about me, one ayah, one verse about me, then go and speak to other people. You can speak minimum what we believe, that we believe in one Allah. You can speak to people about that. You can speak to people about, you know, certain teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like how we avoid certain social problems, like we don't do certain things.
Now, on the flip side to it, certain people, when they act upon the hadith that you have talked about, they come across or they imply as if they're more knowledgeable than the actual shuyukh or a qualified scholar.
Exactly. And
where's the balance?
And I find sometimes people will come and say, they will tell you a lot of information but say, I'm not a scholar. At the same time, I'm not a scholar, but they will try and persuade you in such a way.
Not only persuade, they will talk about fatwas.
I'm not an alim, I'm not a balajanan. But I'm not a balajanan. I'm not a balajanan. এই কথা বলে বলে
মানে ফতোয়া দিয়ে দিচ্ছেন
এবং ওনার যে কথা কিন্তু উনি বলে যাচ্ছেন কিন্তু বলছেন আমি আলিম না আপনারা ভালো জানেন আমি আলিম না আপনি ভালো জানেন ইউর স্কলার ইউ নো বেটার বাট হি জাস্ট স্পিকিং অ্যান্ড স্পিকিং অ্যান্ড নট ইভেন প্রবাবলি অ্যালাউইং দ্য স্কলার টু স্পিক
দ্যাটস ওয়্যার দ্য প্রবলেম ইজ দেন এখানে দেয়ার হ্যাজ টু বি আ ফাইন লাইন বিটুইন বাল্লিগু আননি ওয়া লা আয়া অ্যান্ড দেন ইমপ্লাইং when giving the message that I'm more qualified than actual scholar.
No, everybody should speak according to their knowledge.
Okay.
As soon as they don't know something, or they're not aware, or they're not sure about that, they should just go say very clearly that I'm not sure about that. Let's not pretend as scholars. Even I do not know so many things. And I must say to my musallis, my worshippers, and my people, আমি আমার মুসল্লিদেরকে আমি অনেক সময় বলতে হয় যে আমি এটা জানি না, আমি একটু কনফার্ম করে বলতে
হচ্ছে. What about the viewers?
Exactly. So a lot of time we have to say that we are not sure, but nowadays we have a tendency of saying that we know everything.
Now the other problem, that's true, Karan. We can't say I don't know.
How can you become an imam if you don't know? How can you become a sheikh if you don't know that? But we need to understand that وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no matter how knowledgeable you become, you will not know, you won't know certain things. Even some of the big scholars I've realized, some of the very giant and genius scholars, sometimes you ask them some minor questions, they don't know. And this is what makes us human beings, that we don't know everything. Exactly, and we need to appreciate the fact that, you know, if someone comes and say, if an imam or sheikh or a scholar or even a knowledgeable person comes and say that, let me just confirm that I'm not too sure, then we need to appreciate that at least that person is being honest.
Okay.
And at least that person is going to give the right answers. I've seen actually even on channel sometimes the question comes, if the scholar or if the person who's answering
the guest
doesn't know, or the guest doesn't know, then he just says something like, they just come up with some answers in order to just satisfy the people. But then we need to learn how to say no as well at times. Imam Malik rahimahullah, once he was asked 40 questions. And out of the 40 questions, 36 approximately questions, he said, I do not know. Somebody said, Imam, you are the Imam of Medina al-Munawwara, Darul Hijra. You are the biggest scholar. لا يفتى وبالكم في المدينة. It has been said that if Imam Malik in Medina, nobody has the audacity to give fatwa. But كنو بكتير فتوى دور كنو شاوشنا إمام مالك جد مدينة منورة تكلم.
رحمه الله.
كنت وني أربرو وني بولتشن تربرو وني بولتشن جه شوية تريشتا بروسنير أتترو وني بولتشن أمي جانينا. So somebody asked, how do you say that? Why do you say that? أبني كنو يركم بولتشن. وني بولتشن جه nowadays people just say, and he's talking about that time. The time, of course, the Khairul Qurun, the early and the time of the righteous, rightly guided time era. He's saying that nowadays people keep on saying, I know, I know, I know. But I want to teach people how to say, I do not know. আমি মানুষ থেকে শিখাতে চাচ্ছি যে কিভাবে বলতে হয় আমি জানি না.
One day if he was alive today, what would he have said?
Exactly, yeah, that's right. So coming back to this discussion, so we as Muslims, we believe that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was a great messenger of Allah, the Almighty. Muslims wholeheartedly believe in his miraculous birth. I mean, he was born without any male intervention, without the father, by the will of Allah. We believe that he was born without a father. There is one individual, one prophet, one person in this world was born without parents, and that's Adam alayhi salam, father and mother. And then somebody else,
I mean, without parents.
Without parents, by the will of Allah, and Allah can do whatever he likes. And then Hawa alayhi salam was born without a mother, Eve alayhi salam. And Isa alayhi salam was born without a father, without any male intervention. And that's a miracle, and that's an ayah, sign of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala acting nidorshan. And that's, this fact actually is rejected by even some modern bishops in many churches, that he was born miraculous without any male intervention, without any father. We believe as Isa alayhi salam is a Messiah, translated as Christ. We believe in him, in his miracles, many, many miracles that he performed. Part of the miracles of the noble prophet Isa alayhi salam was that he would be able to heal those who were born blind, and he would be able to heal the leper and bringing the dead people back to the life again. These are the miracles of the noble prophet Isa alayhi salam. Ortat unar mu'jizar modde amra bishwash kori Quran al-Karim kintu porishkar bhabe bolche ورسولا الى بني اسرائيل একজন রাসূলকে بني ইসরাইলের মধ্যে পাঠানো হয়েছিল প্রেরণ করা হয়েছিল اني قد جئتكم بايه من ربكم উনি বলেছেন যে আমি তোমাদের কাছে এসেছি আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিনের কিছু নিদর্শন নিয়ে I came to you with some signs of Allah the Almighty from your Lord. What are these signs? He said, أني أخلق لكم من الطين كهيئة الطير فأنفخ فيه فيكون طيرا بإذن الله. Then he said, what I do is that I make something like bird, and then I breathe into the bird, and it becomes like something like a form of a bird. So he makes something like bird, and he breathes into it, and then it becomes a bird. أني أخلق لكم من الطين كهيئة الطير فأنفخ فيه فيكون طيرا بإذن الله. Then he says, وأبرئ الأكمة. Part of his miracle was that he said, I would be able to heal, and I cure the blind and the leper. وأبرئ الأكمة والأبرص وأحيي الموتى بإذن الله. And I give life back to the dead people. These are my miracles mentioned in the Noble Quran very clearly.
Now that means with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Of course, yes. And these are miracles performed by the prophets in order to prove their nubuwa, prophethood.
My dear viewers, there's a message there, what Shaykh has mentioned, that everything is possible with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he does miracles. And one of the key messages that Shaykh has mentioned here is that let us also learn to say no for things that we don't know for sure. We don't have to say that we always know. And inshallah, may Allah give us the ability to inculcate this habit within ourselves, that if we do not know something, let us check it up with the scholars, with the qualified people, and then pass on the message based on the knowledge or the limited knowledge that we possess. Inshallah, we'll continue our discussion. And in the next segment, we'll be discussing about the celebration that will be the Western part of the world that we are living in. There's different sort of celebration that are coming up. What are these? How should Muslim respond? How should Muslim engage? And how should Muslim interact in this festive period? All of this and many more, inshallah, we'll be discussing in the next segment. Until then, wassalamu alaikum.